like 3 minutes.
Go, go, go. Go pee. Seeing all of you.
People.
So just letting you know.
Yeah.
Did it freeze?
That's right. No, no, people are just talking in the chat.
Yeah, they're talking.
No, they're saying yeah, they're just saying
that's all.
Yeah, it's okay.
Okay. If you see any words that start with F, let me know. I'll pick them out of there.
Do what?
If you see any harsh language, anything like that, just probably nothing we can do. But.
Fantastic.
Fantastic. There you go. That's an F word. Yeah. Sorry, I should mention that. The taller. Yeah.
You may want to
Oh, Daylin already did, but we'll make sure before we start.
Already did what? Can you make sure that we're centered in that when I start it?
Okay. Yeah. So we don't.
And what happens?
That's good. I got my video experts right here.
No, you're good.
I'm just going to go ahead and start.
Remember
where the plug is.
Day.
All right, you can just cuddle here.
What?
All right, look at my mom.
Bed
at my mom. All right, bed at my dad.
I'll lose a few.
Oh my god. That's fine. All
right, and then Jedi, move in a bit.
Sandra said pretty flowers.
Oh, they are pretty.
Oh, thank you.
You want to tell everybody again?
Can you guys hear us?
Everybody hear anything?
Everybody hear?
Can everybody in the stream hear us?
Oh my.
Hi, stream. Hi, chat. Can you hear us?
Okay.
And can we not hear your phones? Please, if you haven't, silence your phones, your devices.
And if you want to go ahead and take a couple pictures, we'll talk for a minute and pretend like we're doing our vows.
Yeah,
we'll take a couple pictures. So, you want to look at
my Marian face, right?
Yeah. We're very excited that you're all here.
Definitely.
So, thank you so much. All right, you're supposed to be looking at me. All right. Okay. All right. Now, if everyone can put the phones away, you can use them as much as you want during the gaming. So that's fine. Okay. So we're gonna go ahead and get started. So we just gotta remember to project so the live stream can hear us too.
Hey, chat. Like and subscribe.
Smash that like button.
Friends and family, loved ones, we're here today to celebrate two of the coolest freaking people I've ever met. I'm honored to be here, officially recognizing the marriage of Joe Martin. I think we all saw it coming. And if you're anything like me, you happy danced at the magic proposal and Joe's subsequent social media meltdown. Their love is unique and sacred and weird and wonderful, and it's as beautiful as any I've ever witnessed. Sometimes things just work, and I'm proud to be their officiant today. While they could have opted for a notary or a secluded courthouse with strangers, they invited us. That's who they are. Whether they're streaming, reporting, creating art, or sharing very, very sweet selfies, Daylena and Joe invite us along. Their love is welcoming, inviting, and inclusive. We're honored by their invitation. It's natural that they included us today. Since their engagement on August 13, 2022, we've watched them bloom, private thoughts made public, revealing the depth of their love. I'd like to read a couple of sentiments from Joe and Daylena to hear from them. Joe said, "Daylena gets me, and gets me in a way that I'm so excited to experience and share and return in droves to them in the years to come. I love when we take pictures together of us doing fun things we both enjoy and get really sappy when I'm sharing them online. I cannot wait to be marrying them and getting this to be the future we both get to live in. Well, Joe, your day is here. This is the moment now that you've dreamed about. These few minutes mark the beginning of the future you get to live in." And Daylena wrote, "It is refreshing to be with someone with endless patience, kindness, and love for me. Joe, you make me a better person. You ground me, you center me, you make me strive to be the best possible version of myself. I could not imagine life without you. I love your laugh and smile and the way you talk to Nana. I love your infinite creativity and artistic talents, and the way you so lovingly teach me new things. You mean the absolute world to me, and I can't wait to marry you. And I just want everyone to know how amazing you are. Well, Dave, today, you unite yourself with this man of endless patience, kindness, and love. This is the moment you get to immortalize how amazing he is. With these sentiments in mind, Day, may I ask you to hold Joe's ring in your hands? And Joe, may I ask you to hold Daylena's ring in your hands?" Friends and family, in person and online, in this moment, we take a breath. We join together with the best of intentions. We hold these two and these tokens of their deep love in our hearts, our good thoughts, our silent affirmative prayers. Dave, please share your vows.
I'm supposed to sum up my indescribable feelings for you in just a few words. Usually I'm writing around other people's words. I live and breathe the anecdotes and sound bites of other people. This is the hardest thing I've ever had to write because you deserve the best of what I can offer. And nothing I put to paper seems good enough. So here we go. I've loved you since April 9th, 2020, when you said to me, "Every bit of my worst day would be worth it if I got to see you at the end of it." I probably loved you even before that, during the times we kept missing one another. One of us single while the other one wasn't, but then vice versa. We've had this connection since our first conversation on Facebook about a decade ago. I love you more with each passing day. And when I think that my heart is close to bursting, it grows bigger to accommodate even more love for you. Every time our cat jumps into our bed and cuddles up to us and you say, "I love our family, I love you more."
Every time I walk in the front door or wake up next to you and you greet me with a smile, I love you more. Being with you, both as a friend and now as your partner, has always been so natural. It's the easiest thing I've ever done in my life. Whether we're watching Star Trek, playing board games, or just sitting together on the couch scrolling through our phones, your presence grounds me and elates me. I wish you could see yourself the way I see you. You're talented and creative and hardworking, but more importantly, you're kind, compassionate, supportive of me in ways I've only ever dreamed of being supported. You view my quirks as features, not flaws. You love me when I'm unable to love myself. You do not merely tolerate me or accept me. You celebrate me. You want me actively, abundantly, and your endless unconditional patience and love makes every day worth living. I've never really felt at home anywhere before you, but the second I stepped foot into your apartment in North Carolina, I had a feeling of coming home, because home isn't always a building or a space. Sometimes it's a person, and you're my person. I have a wallet full of notes you've written me. Whiteboards abound in our house with notes I can't bring myself to erase. You've loved me through my bad days as much as you've loved me on my good days. You've loved me through the worst grief and heartache of my life, losing my dad. He would have loved you so much. He would have been ecstatic to have you as his son-in-law. And I know that both my moms feel the same way. The world is cruel, it's unjust, it's unkind, but I promise you there will always be your light in the darkness, and on the days we can't find joy, we'll find curiosity together. And I promise you I'll take care of myself as much as I take care of you, because you deserve to have someone who loves you as much as I do around for a very long time. I can't wait to see the age lines in both our faces, from years of smiles and laughters as we grow old together. I can't wait for all the memories we have yet to make, and I can't wait to make the world just a little bit better by sharing our love with it. Joe, I love you with all of my heart and my butt, because it's bigger.
Funny one. My dearest Alina. You know what I mean? I promised that I wouldn't do that. But, well, I should preface all this stuff with a big obvious fact. You're weird. You're so incredibly weird. But here we are now, together, in this wonderful place we found. I'm dressed like an assistant manager at Bennigan's, and you look like a keyboardist from Flock of Seagulls. But with all our official, legally binding adult paperwork signed, and we're in love, we're stupid in love, and we're in front of our families and friends, and we're doing this thing. And we've been talking about it on a Sunday. Yeah. Understand when I say things like, you're incredibly weird, it's the greatest compliment and an understatement to who you are. You are my best friend, the greatest teacher, the most attentive listener, and the human being that makes my life worth living. And I hope I show that for you every day. We have such an incredible story that I would never have expected or anticipated, and I'm always happy to share with people. We've begun this amazing journey together, hand in hand. We've got everything and nothing figured out at the same time, and it's okay because we work. And we have the love of many others in this room, as well as our own, to light the way ahead. You also have dead things shipped to the house. And you're so excited to get them. Look at this ethically sourced dead animal. We should put it in the house. And I say, yeah. And then we should put more of them around the house. Okay, sure. the thing is that there's no bad ideas with you. There's nowhere I wouldn't go with you, and nothing I wouldn't do for you. The fact that since meeting you years ago, by just randomly blurting, "I love your column," I just never would have predicted we were here right now, that everything lined up so perfectly to be each other's biggest fan, most trusted confidant, and the other part of each other that was missing. It's just the best surprise, and I don't know how fortunate we were to have fate line up at this exact time and space. As I tell you often, you've saved me, and you complete me. You are so weird. And couldn't be more perfect, because as everybody knows, I'm really weird too. I have no idea how two people can be as weird as we are and also perfectly balanced. We work in a way that still surprises me. You have an ability to take me at my worst days and make me realize I need to knock it off and enjoy what we have. Whether we're breaking out a complicated board game and figuring it out, or sitting on the couch and trying to watch a video of how it's played and giving up, whether we're playing Nintendo Switch in a coffee shop, even though I hate coffee, and I make up for it because I usually beat you in Smash Brothers or whatever. And then you're excited, though, to keep playing. And I'm excited to keep beating you in Smash Brothers. Watching you awkwardly dance in your seat and do that weird thing with your face in public to make me laugh when I'm insisting on being a grump. Watching Joe Bob Briggs talk about... the interstitial about garbage movies like Spookies and Things, and looking at me with this "what the hell was that" type look for what we watched. Have you explained and teach me Pokemon, which I never would have learned ever, and you made me do that, and I'm ever so grateful. No, really, I am. It's fun. Check it out. Seeing your disdain when I talk about kung fu movies and samurai stuff. And yet you deal with it, even though you're looking at your phone or half interested, which is a shame. Meeting our families together, asking each other weird questions this late at night about if you could have your head swapped with the head of another animal, what would it be? And wishing that the other would just kind of shut up and get tired so we could get some much needed sleep. And surprising each other with little things, with symbols of generosity to remind each other that we're thinking about each other. Randomly dancing to Mario Kart music in the living room just because. Yeah. Going places together, being at home together, doing new things, teaching each other something new every day, being excited about things together, and falling more and more in love through it all with each every day, the following day. I tell you every single day that I love you, and you make it better just by being you. It's redundant, but it's the single greatest truth that I know. Today's Sunday, and people have asked, why this Sunday? To which we've met with everybody and said, oh. But henceforth, this is the biggest Sunday I've ever experienced in my entire life. It's a celebration of the official marketing that of the fact that I will for every single day tell you that I love you and repeat it to an obnoxious degree until the end of time. Accepting your proposal to get married was honestly the easiest decision I've ever made. And I'm really glad that you presented it to me in the way that you did. Even though you're a filthy Magic the Gathering card-palming cheat that put an out-of-color card that you can't play in your deck, it's fine. This is fine. It's part of our story. It's the second best part of it when compared to this moment right now. You teach me so many new things because you're legitimately one of the coolest people I've ever met. Sorry. You've come to me with new things that I couldn't have ever learned on my own. I'm always in awe. I feel like I'm with a movie star, probably a Mad Max lead bad guy, depending on what you're saying. I'm so proud of you for your identity, your tenacity, your determination, your intelligence, and your devotion, and your heart. You know exactly who you are, and you're not afraid of that. And I couldn't be more proud if you were fortunate to share this adventure with you. If every single one of us had a splinter of your good qualities, the world would shine for it. I wish I had the levels of awesome you radiate. You know what, I'm going to remind you right now that you can back out right now if you want. No? Okay. Say Margaret Ann Miller. I'm using your full name. I can't wait for us to move ahead with what's felt so right for 3 years-ish and some. I can't wait to wake up every morning with you to take care of our sweet boy Nanook, who's grown to tolerate me rather than hate me by now, for us to get donuts and coffee, to hold your hand all the time and rub your leg while we're driving, to make odd and terrifying faces at each other to get reaction, to listen to every word of what you're telling me, and to build a future with you. I have a quote from a wise person to share that I know we've heard together. It goes like this. As long as there is injustice, whenever a Targaryen baby cries out, whenever a distress signal sounds among the stars, we'll be there. This fine ship, this fine crew, never give up and never surrender. Yeah, it's from Galaxy Quest. I'm sorry, I really wanted to say that in a room full of people. And I'm not going to get the chance again. But it probably doesn't make any sense. Maybe it's the first thing that came to mind because I'm an idiot. But this is one of those things that I know that we watched this movie. This is one of the first movies we watched together. And I just felt it and knew. Like, this resonated with me. And none of the Star Trek Next Generation quotes really seem to line up with this one. I'm going to stop and say we carry on with the ceremony. I wrote a lot, and I could go on for much longer. But you know what? That's what after is for the rest of everything and beyond the infinite. You're wonderful. I love you. I cannot wait to be your partner for life through everything. P.S. I know the state of Florida recognizes this union, that all of our friends are willing to accept what we're doing here. And I know the rings are soon to be on each other's fingers. All the technicalities are laid out, but just for public record, you do owe me a best of 5 series involving Halo Combat Evolved 2 players. Aim high, pistols only, no radar, no shields, 20 frags in order to make this control. Seriously? One more time. Not the last by a long shot. I love you. We're doing the thing. We're finally getting married. For real. For real?
For real.
All right, I'm done.
Oh. Time to exchange rings.
You're all right.
Oh. Oh, thank God.
These rings symbolize an unbroken, eternal love. Wear them proudly, confident in your relationship. Now, your duty as witnesses is also sacred and noble. Daylena, Joe, we vow to affirm your love, to support you in lovely and difficult times. We promise to enthusiastically cheer on your dreams and celebrate your success. We know your futures will be filled with happiness, and we are excited to be part of your journey. Loved ones, if you agree to support these two with your love, companionship, solicited advice, and by possibly buying buttons or tabletop RPGs, please signify by saying or typing, we do.
We do.
Thank you for your papers.
Joe, I ask, do you willingly commit to a lifetime of marriage with Daylena?
Yes.
Do you promise to take care of them as your partner and of yourself for them? Daylena, I ask, do you willingly commit to a lifetime of marriage with Joe?
Yes.
Do you promise to take care of them as your partner and of yourself for him?
I do.
As your officiant, I pray for your success, your peace, and that your lives together are happier than your wildest dreams. Loved ones, by the legal power entrusted to me, I proudly proclaim Joe and Daylena are married.
Mine's not as good.
You know.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, Joe, we're definitely friends because you stole some of my thunder with your vows. So I'm gonna ad lib a little bit here.
That's fine.
Or maybe I'll just repeat what you said.
Yes. Here. Yes.
So hello everyone. I'm incredibly honored that Joe thought I was a bad enough dude to be his best man.
Yeah.
I met Joe about 20 years ago. He was working in a bookstore in the mall, and I had just moved to town, to Sebring. Oh no, I'm on camera now.
Yeah.
I hadn't really made any friends in town yet, and I had heard that Joe was running a Star Wars role-playing game. I'd always been interested in tabletop role-playing games, but I never had really gotten a chance to play one. So I talked to Joe, and he invited me to play. At that game, I rolled a one, and he determined that I was holding my lightsaber upside down, and I ignited it right through my leg. It was hilarious, it was great, and we've been friends ever since. I can say that in those 20 years, I've seen Joe go through some difficult times and also have some great personal moments. And I've never seen Joe as happy as he is right now. This is the part where I include a quote.
Is it the same quote?
No. It's coming later. Being deeply loved by someone gives you strength, while loving someone deeply gives you courage. Above all else, Daylena, I want to thank you for loving and strengthening my best friend. I am forever in your debt. So, this is the part. Live long.
Oh.
Prosper. Go where no couple has gone before. Never give up. Never surrender to infinity and beyond. Congratulations to you both.
Do you have any Star Trek quotes in
here? I didn't get that memo.
Well, he didn't either. He just figured it out.
Wow. Okay. For those who don't know me, my name is Danny, and I've had the pleasure of calling Daylena my best friend for the past 11-ish years. I met Daylena in the most Daylena way possible. They interviewed me for a story that they were working on for, you know, work. And because, you know, of course they did. And shortly after that, we started working together, and the rest, as they say, is history. Having Daylena for a best friend is an experience. They're loud in every sense of the word, with their aesthetics, their beliefs, and even the way that they walk around with the giant ring of keys and wallet, which we actually were able to get from them before this started. But the great thing about Daylena is that you know exactly what you're going to get with them, because they wear everything right there on their sleeve, sometimes literally. And when they find a new interest, they don't just casually observe or dip their toe. No. They dive headfirst into the deep end and explore every crevice of that interest. I remember introducing them to Doctor Who back when we were working together, and the next thing I know, they're making a giant beetle backpack for their Donna Noble cosplay. which you rocked, by the way. And they don't grow tired of things and set previous interests to the side either. When they love something, it's forever. And that brings me to Joe. When Daylena started dating again, I was nervous. I've seen them literally hide parts of themselves away, scared that they'll be too much for any romantic partner. And then they told me about this friend they had named Joe. They told me he's a huge nerd, they've been friends for years, that there could be something more there, and they took a chance, and I would say it paid off. Yeah. Now, when Daylena told me he's a huge nerd, yeah, they definitely downplayed that. You see, Joe is also loud in his art, his interests, and opinions. And the passion he has for creating new games about dystopian space police, disgruntled coffee shop employees, and to be honest, I'm not sure what else he's working on right now, but I can't wait to play it when it's done. Another thing he's passionate about is Daylena, obviously. I told Dave this on Friday about how Joe reached out to me shortly after they started dating to tell me about his intentions, but I didn't give them the exact quote, which I'm going to do now. Quote, I just don't want you to think I'm the kind of person to string them along in something that isn't going somewhere. And stuff. End quote. So I guess Joe is also the kind of person who dives headfirst into the deep end. And when he loves something, it's forever. So here's to forever. I'm so happy for you both, Daylena and Joe.
Daylena Miller, the Gall Boulevard, Pizza Hut.